powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
Supernatural multiplication, and he wants to multiply you in all aspects of your life. His will is for you to increase in all areas of your life. God wants you to increase in your job. He wants you to increase in your finances. He wants you to increase in your career. He wants you to increase in your dream. An increase is the will of God. That is what God's will is. Increase is the will of God. And God's intention for increasing us is to use us for his glory. I said God's intention for increasing us is to use us for his glory. God's intention for increasing us is to bring us to a place where we can boldly say to people, God is a good God. You know, you can't boldly announce to people that God is a good God when you have not experienced his goodness. And God wants you to taste of his goodness. That was why the scripture said, taste and see that the Lord is good. It said, taste and see that the Lord is good. So our God is a God of multiplication. I'd like us to go to Deuteronomy chapter 1 next morning. In Deuteronomy chapter 1, I'd like us to do... Deuteronomy chapter 1, we're going to look at verse 10. In Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 10, and look at what it says. It says, the Lord your God has multiplied you. That's a powerful word. It says, the Lord your God has multiplied you. Multiplication comes from God. There is a difference between multiplication and addition. Multiplication accelerates. I said what? Multiplication accelerates. If you truly want to see acceleration in your life, it comes when God begins to multiply. So Moses brought forth a prophetic word. He recognized what God has done. Then he said, the Lord your God have multiplied you. Has multiplied you. And God's interest is to see you walk in multiplication. God's interest is to see you do what? Walk in multiplication. That everything around you that is consistent with God's word, God wants it to multiply. Everything around you that is consistent with God's word, God wants it to multiply. We got to learn to train ourselves, like we said in the first service, train yourself to trust God. Train yourself to trust God. Train yourself to trust in what God can do. Train yourself to trust in who God is. Train yourself to believe in what God can do for you. So Moses said that the Lord your God has multiplied you. So right now we're looking at how to walk in supernatural multiplication. How to walk in what? In supernatural multiplication. Number one, if we're going to walk in supernatural multiplication, we must be willing to respond to God's instruction. If we're going to walk in supernatural multiplication, we must be willing to respond to God's instruction. Our God is a giver of word. God gives word to his people. The purpose why he gives them the word is to provide direction and leadership for them. God gives you word for the purpose of providing leadership and direction for us. So we must be willing to follow God's instruction if we want to walk in supernatural multiplication. In Genesis chapter 12, we see how a man responded to God's instruction and his whole life changed. He responded to God's instruction. In Genesis chapter 12, we can read from verse 1. He said, "Now the Lord had said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country. The Lord had said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land I will show thee." That was a word from God to Abraham. He said, get thee out. Now let me say this to us. Our comfort zone can be an enemy to our future if we don't handle our comfort zone with the knowledge of our purpose. I want to say it again. I said our comfort zone can be an enemy to our future if we don't handle our comfort zone with the knowledge of God's purpose for our life. I'm going to say it again. I said our comfort zone can be an enemy to our future. Our comfort zone can be an enemy to our future if we don't handle the comfort zone with the knowledge of God's purpose for our life. If we don't handle the comfort zone with the knowledge of God's purpose for our life, that comfort zone can be an enemy to our future. A comfort zone can be likened to a place of self-satisfaction. A place of what? A place of self-satisfaction. I think I've had it enough here. I think I'm okay right now. But God is saying, I want to do more. God is saying, I want to step into your next dimension. I want to make new things to happen around you. So the word of the Lord came to Abraham. He was in his comfort zone. A comfort zone is a place you're used to. A comfort zone is a place where you can make decisions as a result of the confidence you have about that place in your life. It's a place where you can stand up and make a decision based on this and that. You're comfortable there. It's a place for a point of being relaxed. A point where you can say, well, I've arrived at this point. But that can be an enemy to where God wants to take you to. So whenever God wants to move us out of our comfort zone, he gives us a prophetic word. And that prophetic word sometimes in the natural does not line up with our thinking, does not line up with our expectation, may not line up with what we believe as a person or what we believe as individuals. It may not line up with it, but when that word comes, it comes with the intention for you to break that limitation. A comfort zone can represent a limitation in your life. A comfort zone can represent a limitation in your life. It can represent a limitation, a place where you're comfortable, but relax, a place where, okay, here is good for me. But God is saying there is grace. You can go from good to grace. God is saying you can go from good to great. God is saying you can go from good to great. God is saying you can go from one dimension to the other. So when the prophetic words came and said, leave your father's house. Look at this. Genesis 12, verse 1 says, now the Lord has said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country. He's used to his country. He knows people in his country. If he has a challenge, he will walk up to two friends and two persons and ask them for help and he will get help. And the Lord was saying, get out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land I will show you. This is a faith adventure. This is what? This is a faith adventure. Abraham was about to start the journey of his destiny. Or we can say Abraham is about to start the journey of multiplication, the journey of supernatural increase. And how does this journey begin? It begins with a prophetic word from God. Now let me say this to you. Don't try to do anything God is not giving you what to do. Don't try to start something when God has not given you what to start it. Zeal is not enough to sustain a vision. I want to say it again. I said zeal is not enough to sustain a vision. Zeal is not enough to sustain a dream. This is where people get tired. This is where people get internally they are frustrated. Internally they cannot move forward. Because they allow zeal to start it. But zeal is like a fuel and or a gas. After a while, the person runs out of a gas. So we don't just need, we need more than a zeal. So Abraham here did not start the journey. The journey started with a prophetic word from God. Just that people are relocating from one city to the other doesn't mean you should relocate. You should be able to hear what God is saying to you. If someone comes to you right now and give you a prophetic word, God wants you to relocate to the next city. Yes, he has given the word, but you need to hear from God for yourself. Because if you don't hear from God, you don't have the right conviction for stepping out. In this situation here, God was talking to Abraham. He was talking to him. He said, leave your father's house to a land that I will show you. This man was hearing from God. Train yourself to hear the voice of God. One of the major responsibilities as a believer is to train yourself to respond to the voice of God. It's to train yourself to recognize the voice of God. It's to train yourself to walk or flow in the will of God. This is part of your responsibility as a believer, to train yourself. And Paul was writing in Romans 12, verse 2, he said, be not conformed to this world. In Romans 12, verse 3 said, be not conformed to this world, but be a transformed. You can't just be making decisions based on feeling because you will never get into the will of God. You can't be making decisions based on offense. You can't get into the will of God. You have to train yourself to trust in the voice of God. Training yourself to trust in the voice of God is the key to experiencing supernatural multiplication. I said, training yourself to trust in the voice of God is the key to experiencing supernatural multiplication. Training yourself to respond to the voice of God. Training yourself to acknowledge the voice of God. All your friends will be saying, let's go to the west, or let's go to the north, or let's go to the east. Let me say this to you. Going to the east with your friend will solve your problem. It's hearing what God is saying to you as an individual that will change your circumstance. Your circumstance. It's hearing the voice of God. It's hearing what God is saying. In Genesis chapter 12, we saw Abraham as a photograph of a man who heard the voice of God and the outcome of that voice. He heard the voice of God. And when he heard the voice of God, he moved in the direction of the voice he heard. This is where a lot of people have stagnated. This is where a lot of people cannot go to where God wants them to get to. Why? Because they are not training themselves to recognize the voice of God for their life. And if you don't recognize God's voice for your life, it's difficult for you to unlock the will of God for your life. It's difficult. It's difficult. Most of the success we're seeing or the things we're doing never came as a result of trying to do brainstorming. How long will I brainstorm? How long? You need to train yourself to know when a particular season is ending and to know when a new season is starting. You need to be able to know that. You should be able to train yourself to understand that God is moving me into this area. God is connecting me to this person. You know, when we don't train ourselves to understand the voice of God, we can't even recognize the relationship that God has put us into. We won't be able to recognize the relationship that God has given to us, the relationship that is connected to our destiny. There is a relationship connected to your destiny. There is a relationship that God is going to use to increase you in life, multiply you. There is a lot of people are out of it. place. They are out of place. Have you ever had this experience when your bone is out of place? Have anybody had experience where their bone shifted?
Have anybody here?
Anybody? Okay. If you notice that you have pain in that area. You have pain. There was a pain in that area because the bone shifted. For some people, they can't walk very well because the bone has shifted. The bone shifted, and right now they are going through a severe pain. This is what happens to people who are not in the will of God. The pain increases. Why the pain increases? Because your provision is in His will. I want to say it again. I said, your provision is in the will of God. And this is why we have to train ourselves in the Word of God. To me, the Bible is not about impressing the pastor, impressing anyone. To read the Bible is all about training yourself to develop sensitivity, to respond, to be sensitive to the things of the Spirit of God. That when God is talking to you, you are quick to respond. When God is talking to you, you are quick to respond. You're training yourself. Someone may be ahead of you right now, maybe he's doing this, he's doing that. If you can get one word from God, you will see yourself speeding. The speed does not come from effort. The speed comes from understanding. I said the speed does not come from effort. The speed comes from understanding. It comes from the clarity of the will of God. That is where speed comes from. And suddenly this guy begins to rage, you know, begins to speed up. Why? Because he has an understanding of God's will for his life. He has an understanding of where God has connected him to. He has an understanding of where God is taking him to. He has an understanding of what God's purpose is for his life. He has an understanding. So in Genesis chapter 12, let's look at verse 1 again. Praise God. In Genesis 12, verse 1, it said, now the Lord has said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country. This was quite prophetic. It was a prophetic instruction. He said, and from thy kindred, from thy father's house, unto a land I will show you. Now, until he shows him the land, he has no land. I said, what? Until he shows him the land, he has no land. He said, unto a land I will show you. That's what it means. There is no one that is going to aid Abraham to this land. There is no one that is going to come to Abraham and say, well, this is the land. It is God who said, I will show you a land. And there is someone watching this broadcast right now, or when this service connects to this service, God wants to show you the land. The land may be likened to a business idea. The land may be likened to a relationship. The land may be likened to an insight, a concept. The land may be likened to an understanding of a particular solution to a problem. The land may be likened to you giving a call to someone that will tell someone to help you. The land said, I will show you a land. So Abraham started this journey on multiplication, but this multiplication will happen as Abraham continuously obeyed the voice of God. As Abraham continuously obeyed the voice of God, he's going to walk in supernatural multiplication. As he continuously obeyed the voice of God, how can I be making a decision based on emotion? How can I be making a decision based on what someone said? I have to make my decision based on what God is revealing to me. What is God saying to me? What man does he want to show to me? Is it a business idea? Is it a career idea? Is it an idea to go into real estate? Is it an idea about gas and oil? Is it about idea about fashion, designs, modeling? What does it? What is he calling me to do? There is a land God wants to show to you. And your multiplication is in the land God reveals to you. This is powerful. Your multiplication is in the land that God revealed to you. Your multiplication is in the land. Let me say this to you. Until you are in that land, you can't see the multiplication. Until you are in that land that God revealed to you. So your most important thing, the most important thing in your life right now is not just money, it's training yourself to hear the voice of God for what He wants you to do. Because there are people that have made so much money and they lost so much money. They lost the money. Why did they lose the money? Because they were not in the land where God has shown to them. There is a land for you. There is a place where God is taking your gift into.
There is a place where your gifting can be spotted out. There is someone who is responsible for taking your gifting to the next level. People don't know this. This is why it's important that you learn to interact with the Holy Spirit. You learn to interact with the Holy Ghost. If you don't interact with the Holy Spirit, you may not be able to connect with the relationship that have the synergy to accelerate your vision. He said to Abraham here, he said, I want to show you that. If you're going to walk in supernatural multiplication, God must reveal something to you. He has to show you something. You know, a few days ago, it's on Saturday, I had a dream. In that dream, we were singing this song, How Great is Our God? Sing with me, How Great is Our God? You know, that was the song. It was going and it was so strong. You know, I was hearing it, and then that vision that he was telling me the reason for that song. That a time in that vision, I saw a woman that was pregnant, and then I told the woman, you're going to have twins. In that vision, when I woke up, I knew what I need. I didn't say betting season. I knew it's how great is our God. Sing with me, how great. And sometimes what God will do is to drop a prophetic dream in your spirit. It's to drop a prophetic dream in your spirit. Sometimes it drops a vision in your spirit. It drops a dream in your spirit. Sometimes God will show someone a vision. And say, God, share this vision with Pastor. Maybe you saw something about the local church. Maybe you saw something. It drops it in your spirit. And suddenly you begin to realize that this is not ordinary. Can I say this to someone this morning? Whatever God reveals to you empowers you to take the lead. Whatever God reveals to you empowers you to take the lead. If you're truly going to take the lead, there are things God wants to reveal to you. There are things God wants to show to you. There are things God wants to reveal to you. There are things God wants to give you understanding about. There are things He wants to show to you. This is why as you pray in the Spirit, it helps you to be sensitive to the will of God. As you pray, so pray in the Spirit, it helps you to be sensitive to the will of God. It helps you to be sensitive to His plan. God can put you in a place, but the place does not look popular right now. It doesn't look popular. How can my voice be heard in this place? How can I be? You know, some people are saying, I want exposure. I was telling my wife, I said, I have not run around looking for someone to lay hands on me. I'm going to run around. Oh, this person is in town. Oh, this great man of God is in town. Oh, this person is in town. Oh, this person is in town. So you're driving from here to here. You know, like some people, they're looking for this person's anointing. They're looking for that. I'm not looking for anybody's anointing. I'm anointed already.
Amen.
I know what I'm called to do. I'm not confused. If God leads me to a person to relate with, I relate with them. If God did not lead me, I stay where I am and do what God has called me to do. It will spring forth by itself. He said, I will do a new thing that you do what? And that you spring forth. It's not in the hands of man for your life to spring forth, for your vision to spring forth. It's God who causes men to come in. The men He has not given to you, you can't take. No matter how you hang around them, they will never see you. I'm telling you. Yes. I said, no matter how you hang around them, they cannot see you. It is God who causes people to remember you. It is God who puts your burden in the hearts of people. It is God who causes people to say, I want you to help this guy. I want you to help this person. I want you to stand with them. Because when you are in the land that God has revealed to you, then there is milk and honey in that land. There is provision in that land. There is increase in that land. That is why your walk of multiplication, if you're going to walk in supernatural multiplication, you must train yourself to believe in what God is saying, not what you're feeling. You must train yourself to believe in what God is saying, not how you feel. Look at verse 2 said, and I will make of thee a great nation. These words are the very people that formed the destiny of Abraham. These were the very words that formed the destiny of Abraham. Abraham was a great man because God spoke into his life. Abraham was a great man because he believed the things that God said concerning his future. He believed the things that God said concerning where he's going to. Someone may have despised you or disdain you or look at you and said, well, you're not productive, you're not this, you're not that. All you got to do is to stay with the voice of God. That is what I've done for 20 years. What I've done for 20 years was to stay with the voice of God and never acknowledge my feeling and never allow how I feel to be a distraction to the vision. Never allow how I feel to betray what I believe. Never allow how I feel to be the reason for making poor decisions. I choose to stick with it. There is something about staying with what God has called you to. If God can trust you with his voice, he can trust you with your future. I want to say it again. I said, if God can trust you with his voice, he can trust you with your future. If he can't trust you with his voice, how can you step into your future? Abraham trusted the voice of God. He knew it was the voice of God. If you look at Genesis chapter 12, verse 4, in Genesis 4, verse 12, it said, so Abraham departed as the Lord had spoken. Why did he depart? Because he trusted in the voice of God. There is trusting the voice of God. There is making decisions according to the voice of God. There is thinking according to the voice of God. There is an expectation according to the voice of God. There is an action that is based on the voice of God. There is a relationship that is based on the voice of God. There is a connection that is based on the voice of God. If you can get his voice, you can take care of your future. His voice, our strategy, the voice of God is to walk in supernatural multiplication. Train yourself. This is why your major target in 2017 should be that you will grow in the word of God. This is how you multiply 1,000 times more. Your major target should be how to increase your spiritual capacity. How to increase your word base. How to increase your word base. How to increase your word base. A lady was giving me a testimony, was it 3 weeks ago, that she was in a taxi and someone was playing our teaching in that taxi. And then she had to ask the person, please, would you give me this teaching? Please, beg the person. And the person finally released the teaching to her. And she said her husband will always say to her, can you put that teaching for me? You know, what you hear may be deciding what you believe. I said, what you hear may be deciding what you believe. And what you hear may be deciding how you think. What you hear may be deciding what you believe. What you hear may be deciding what you think. What you hear may be deciding what you'll be expecting. What you hear may be deciding what you believe, may be deciding what you think, may be deciding what you should expect, what you hear. It said in Romans 10:17, it says, so then faith cometh by hearing. How does faith come? It comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. This is how you advance your life. This is how you advance your dream. This is how you advance your vision, by hearing. What is God saying? Pay attention. At a particular point, you cannot be experimenting with your life, my brothers and sisters. You cannot. At a particular time, you don't hang out with people who are not going your direction. At a particular point, you begin to make decisions of destiny, decisions of the future, decisions of where God is taking you to. I need to hook up with this one more. I need to stay with this one more. I need to. Now, at a particular point of my life, I can't even go to the market and buy clothes. I can't even walk into a shop to buy clothes. All I was to buy the books to buy, the tapes to listen to God's word. I was just listening to things that would empower me. I was listening to things that will help me develop the energy to pursue the dream that God has entrusted to my care. Abraham departed because he trusted the voice of God. Abraham departed because he trusted the voice of God. He is making decisions based on what God has revealed to you. This man called Abraham here, he refused the circumstances around him to stop him from walking in the multiplication God has put in his life. There is a multiplication coming into your life.
Amen.
There is a multiplication with your name on it. There is a multiplication that God wants you to experience concerning your job, concerning your finances, concerning your career. There is a multiplication that God wants you to experience in life. God wants you to multiply. He wants you to multiply. God wants you to multiply. Back to that scripture. Genesis chapter 12. Genesis chapter 12 verse 4 says, so Abraham departed as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him, and Abraham was 75 years old when he departed from Haran. Abraham was 75 years old. You know, when you look at the age of this is an age where people say it's no more possible. This is the age they say you cannot have it in life. This is the age they will say you're too good for it. This is the age they say it's not possible. This is the age it looks like all the dreams have ended. But that was where God started Abraham with. A man of 75 years old, no child, but has one resources, which is the voice of God that came to him. His departure was based on the reveal with the Lord. His departure was based on the revealed will of God. He departed from Haran. He left that place to where God was calling to. He said, I will show you a land. Then he packed his bags. He packed his bag knowing that God cannot fail. He packed his bag believing that whatever God has spoken will come to pass. He packed his bag with an expectation that the God I trust does not change in attitude. He packed his bag with an expectation that there are miracles ahead of me. He packed his bag with an expectation that the provision is ahead of me. You see, those who walk by faith don't judge their life based on where they are. They judge their life based on what God is revealing to them. I want to say it again. I said, those who walk by faith don't judge their life based on where they are. They judge their life based on what God is revealing to them. That is how they judge their life. Not based on where they are, based on what God is revealing. What is God saying right now? That is what has kept me. The voice of God has kept me. I woke up and I sleep and I woke up. I said, God, I thank you because we are there. I woke up and I said, Lord, I thank you because we are there. I woke up and I can see to read that this ministry is going to the nations. We are going everywhere. We are there. I woke up with an excitement knowing that the future is brighter than my past. I woke up with an expectation knowing that there is a greatness inside of me. I woke up with an expectation that everything is moving in the direction of the will of God. I refuse to worry, because when you have God's word concerning anything, you have to pay attention to God's word. If you have the word of God concerning any area of your life, you are expected to pay attention to that word. You are expected to pay attention. Why is it that the people are drifting? They drift here, they drift here, they drift this way. They are not consistent in their belief. And that is how you see them drifting for 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. Nothing to show for it. They keep hopping from place to place. Because they don't know the scripture said that those who are planted in the house of our God, he said, they will flourish in the pot of our God. There is something about being planted that causes increase to spring forth. There is something about being planted. And when you're planted in something, you know when I'm going to come and clap for you and thank you and say, you're looking for encouragement. There are people that every time they're looking for encouragement. Every time they're looking for encouragement. You cannot live like that. If you're always looking for encouragement, you will soon be frustrated. If you're always looking for encouragement, you'll soon be tired. The Bible said, and David encouraged himself in the Lord his God. He encouraged himself. In Joshua chapter 1 verse 6, and God said to Joshua, be strong and be courageous. Don't be looking for encouragement. Run to this place. Please can you encourage me? Or please can you encourage me? You've got to learn to be strong. You've got to learn. When the eagle gives birth to the eaglet, it has to teach that eaglet how to fly. The first day of the flying, the eaglet will think that the mother eagle is, or the father eagle is so wicked. Oh, why is it allowing me to struggle like this? his car. And it may come in down, flapping like that, strongly coming. Before we get to the front, it pisses up again. Training the wings. Some people need to train their wings to fly. They are still struggling to fly. They are still struggling to fly. They are not training their wings of faith. They are looking for encouragement all the time. Someone needs encouragement. You know we need encouragement now. You know we need encouragement. You cannot win like that. You cannot be the kind of man. You cannot be a warrior. Warriors are people who create their own motivation. Warriors are people who create their own motivation. Warriors, faith, warriors are people who pick themselves up and say, I can do it. Come on. I can do it. Stop waiting for people to give you confirmation, try to encourage her. And that's why I say a lot of people are not rising to greatness. That's why I say a lot of people, they have been shut down, their dreams are shut down, they can't make it in life, they are struggling because they are always waiting for convenience, encouragement, you know, things like that. You, Abraham here, who was encouraging him? That prophet, the Bible said that Abraham believed God and it was counted for him for righteousness. He believed God. This kind of rugged faith, aggressive faith, a bulldog kind of faith, a driving faith, a faith that is stubborn, a faith that cannot be stopped by circumstances, a faith that roars, the faith that advances, the faith that keeps moving, the faith that lays hold, the faith that understands that the future belongs to me. That kind of faith, when people say there is a casting down, when you say there is a lifting up, that is a kind of faith in church to do your assignment. That's the kind of faith. That's the kind of faith it takes. He said that Abraham believed God. It was counted for him. He said, he staggered not at the promises of God through unbelief. There were reasons to stagger, but he refused to stagger. There were reasons to walk out and say, well, I've been here for 5 years. I've been here for 10 years. I've been here all of these years. But what am I seeing? That is how a lot of people shut down their destiny. That is why a lot of people walk out of their greatness. They were counting years. They were not increasing in faith. They were counting how many years they have been in ministry. How many years they have been doing the business. They are counting years instead of developing faith to be able to live. God, are you here to count how many years you have been doing what you're doing? Or are you here to know the voice of God to pursue your dream aggressively with a passion, with a boldness? What are you doing? A lot of people are counting years and they are losing focus of the vision. A man of God said, what is 5 years? Are you ready? He said, what is 10 years? What is 15 years? What is 20 years? Then he said, what is 25 years? Are you ready? If God opens this door, do you think you have the driving capacity to pursue?
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
Are you ready?
I'm ready. Jesus. Don't be counting it. Some people are counting it. They're not reading. They are not studying. And then they give them platform. Their accents were so stuck on their mouth, they can't speak to people. They can't even flow. They are counting years instead of developing, working on themselves. They are counting years when God is saying, be getting ready. Yeah. I'm ready. I'm ready. How ready are you? Are you ready to be able to drive this thing for 20 years? Are you ready to drive this thing for years to come? How ready are you? What is the capacity? What is your potential? What is your strength? Some people say they are ready, but they are not ready. If they hit the road that they're running, they won't be able to stay long. They are not ready. And God is not the one holding you from making the impact. It's that your own preparedness has been the major problem. There are doors that will open, that door can swallow you up. I'm telling you, you may lose your focus because the capacity is not developed. So God is looking and saying, little by little. There are people that is working with them little by little. But there are people who look at them and say, this guy is ready. I can open the door of the nations for him because he has the deep capacity. There are things that you can't handle. You may pray about it, you may talk about it, but God will watch your faith gauge. He will watch your faith volume. He will watch your faith dimension. He will look at you and say, is she ready? You know, like the spies that went to check the land. They came back and they said, the land is a good land. It's a beautiful place. But the giants are in the land. Lack of preparation led to poor confession. Lack of preparation. He said, but the land, there are giants in the land. There are all kinds of people in the land. They are the Amorites and all the Jebusites. They surround the land. But you know what happened? There was somebody called Caleb. And he came and said, hey, keep quiet. Let us go once and possess the land. Why was he talking that way? The spirit of faith training in the world. His faith capacity has been enlarged. Then he can be able to look at those first spies or more and say, keep quiet. It's time to lay hold. And God said, I'm going to give it to him and to Joshua because they have another spirit. This is not the spirit of timidity. This is not the spirit that prayed. Do you have the Joshua kind of spirit? This another spirit. A man who will take charge. It's not just talking. You have capacity. Hallelujah. For where you're going. Have you developed your capacity for your dream? Because some people will come into your life and will walk out. You have the capacity to handle the shots. Do you have the capacity to handle betrayal? Do you have the capacity to handle accusation? Do you have the capacity to handle rejection? Do you have the capacity to handle loneliness if it happens to get to that point? Do you have the capacity to stand if you are the only person standing? Do you have the capacity to keep doing what is right even when it's not working, but you know God is talking to you and you still in that lane? Do you have the capacity to abide in your place of assignment even when it does not look like it's flourishing? Do you have the capacity to walk away from all distraction and keep standing where God wants you to stand? My friends, listen to this. No one gets to the top without developing the capacity to stay at the top. No one gets to the top without developing the capacity to stay. The capacity to stay. The capacity. Many years ago, when God started talking to me about the nations, He said, get yourself ready for the nations. Get yourself ready for the nations. Get yourself ready for the nations. Get yourself ready for the nation. He was singing it like a song in my ear. I thought it was going to be a very long time. When God is talking to you right now, so you may think it's going to take a long time, you will be surprised that the next 2 weeks nothing is going on.
Amen.
And that is why you need to begin to train yourself. You need to begin to develop yourself. Don't worry about opportunity. Your well-trained opportunities will come. Don't worry about your platform. Don't worry about platform. Don't worry about connection. That is not what you should be worrying about. Be thinking about developing your capacity. One meeting can take you to the whole world. One meeting. One manifestation of the gifts of God around you and the knowledge of God that we display can change entire human history. So this is why you don't need to worry about, I need a connection, I need this person, I need that person. What you need is to be developed. What you need is to be spending time with God. What you need to be doing is to be sharpening your skill. What you need to be doing is to be trusting God. What you need to be doing is to be studying, building up your most holy faith, getting yourself ready, because there are doors that open. If you don't have the capacity, those doors can be the reason for your downfall. Those same doors. Because no maturity to handle the doors. There was no maturity to handle those doors. And there is someone watching this broadcast right now, and the Holy Ghost is saying, enlarge your capacity for more. And I share this in a round of the service. In John Gospel chapter 2, the word of the Lord came, Mary went to them and said, they have no wine. In John Gospel chapter 2, and Jesus said, my time have not come. Look at that. In John Gospel chapter 2, you read from verse 1 to 7, and you get that story there. And he said, my time have not come. He said, my time have not come. And Mary went back to the crowd and said to them, whatsoever he said to you, do it. What was that Mary had strained herself to function by faith. Jesus said his time has not come. How does that connect with Mary telling the people that whatsoever he said to you, do it? One thing about the spirit of faith is that it goes ahead prophesying. The spirit of faith goes ahead declaring. The spirit of faith goes ahead believing. The spirit of faith goes ahead declaring that look at what God is going to do. I see this coming to pass. I see this happening. That is what happened when an individual operates with the spirit of faith. And you know, when she went to them and he said to them, whatsoever he said to you, what did he say? He said to you what? He said, do it. And after that instruction, the people's faith were ready. And a few minutes later, Jesus came and said, fill the water pot. Imagine if Mary had not trained herself to speak prophetically. Imagine if Mary had not trained herself to learn to trust in the Lord, even when the Lord said the time has not come back. You know what it means to someone? You went to them and said, can you give me the money? And they said, there is no money. Then you went to tell somebody you're owing, that's what I'm going to pay you. The person that's now saying will give you the money said, there is no money. And you went ahead and told someone, I'm paying you tomorrow, that same person is going to bring the money. See, you can't say things like that except you know where you are rooted. I'm about to go to someone right now. And so when Mary said to them, Mary said to Jesus, they have no wine. And Jesus said, my time have not come. That is enough discouragement to bring a setback. But you know what Mary did? He went to the people and said to them, whatsoever he said to you, whatsoever you want, he said to you, do it. And when that word came forth, then a few minutes later, here comes Jesus and said, fill the water pot. And he said, draw from it. Imagine moving from saying, my time has not come, to giving an instruction. That is why you must be ready. Because you may be in one season right now, but the next few seconds are another season. They said, you just came to this service, there was not much money. 2 minutes later, there was so much money. From one season to another. Let's rise and begin to talk to the Lord. Oh, Mashaka, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we thank your holy name. We magnify you. You are the reason for our worship. That God will drop a word in your heart. A word that will move you to your next level. A word that will move you to your next dimension. A word that will empower you to take the lead. A word that will take you to high places. A word that will encourage you to manifest the purpose, to manifest the agenda of God, to manifest the will of God, to manifest God's plan, to manifest God's intention. Training yourself to trust God. Training yourself to trust the word of God. Training yourself to trust his will. Training yourself to trust his counsel. Training yourself to trust his purpose. Training yourself to believe that God is your provider. You train yourself to rely on God. You train yourself to believe God. You train yourself to believe God. You train yourself to rely on his will. You gotta train yourself. You gotta train yourself on faith. You gotta begin to walk on yourself, to begin to arrive, that your faith will rise in his will, in his plan, in his purpose. Lord, we thank you. Glory, Makalina. Let someone pray in the Holy Ghost right now. Likando Shakamba. Likama Sakata Lamaba. Likama Sakata Lamba Rande Sakamba. Likaba. Likama Sukata Lamaba. Likama Sakata Lamaba. Train yourself to believe God. Train yourself to believe his word. Train yourself to rely on the word of God, on the will of God, on the plan of God, on the purpose of God. Train yourself to walk by faith. Train yourself to rely on the things that he has said to you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Ghost. If you're watching this broadcast right now, you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Or maybe you are in this service right now and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You can repeat this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God have raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. The prayer with us, God bless you. We encourage you to stay with Faithman TV. Come and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, Faithman Teaching and Beauty. God bless you and do enjoy your day.